This is a 3D printer for kids that does it right. My 6-year-old daughter can use it without my help. It has a beautiful big screen where she can choose what to print. It prints fast enough and the price is right. You can slice models yourself, but there are hundreds of models ready to print, and kids don't need a phone or a computer. I will show you a bunch of things we've printed so far, and some of the components are surprisingly better than what I had on real printers. Let's take a look now on Geek Detour. So this is a toy, a good one.
It looks like a washing machine.
There was just a couple of steps that I had to guide my daughter, but she could do everything herself, which makes her super proud.
Yes, that's for sure.
It came with a 250 grams spool in black.
It should have been pink.
But you can use regular 1 kilogram spools too. We'll talk about it later. It worked out of the box. As soon as you turn the printer on, you have stuff to print right away, even without internet. But Wi-Fi works great, and I wish other printers had a screen like this. You don't need tweezers to enter your password. Sophie chose this articulated dragon with 3 heads. I need to disclose something. When Kidoodle contacted me, I loved what I saw, and I would need at least 1 week to actually test it with my daughter, so we could print things for real.
It's going super fast.
And I could watch her using it. But my schedule was full. Kidoodle agreed to pay for 1 week of my time, so technically this is a sponsored video. But I will tell you things as they are. The dragon, she loved it. And this is important. I have excellent 3D printers that you can print perfect pieces for clients. This is a toy. It works. It prints small things. They have fun. It doesn't have a heated bed, and you must use glue stick for good results. I showed Sophie how to do it. The first time she rushed it and she missed some spots.
Here to stop.
Okay.
See, look.
Whoa.
See this part here?
Yeah.
See, let's do again. Oop. All the parts of the horse.
And I like this. It is an opportunity to help her pay attention to details, to spread the glue covering the whole plate, to make it uniform, and after it prints, learn to wash out the glue from the prints, and to clean the plate, and to put glue again. Well, after she got it, she was on her own.
What are you doing?
Looking at my bunny.
So this is quite clever. When you choose one of the online models, it starts warming up and preparing the printer right away, even when it's still downloading the model.
She's the driver.
Sophie didn't wash this one. Yeah, see? A unicorn!
Draw a heart.
Oh.
A real heart. Make it nice and colored.
This looks like a bearing, but it's not. Everything is free, but only the middle spins.
The catalog of models has lots of articulated animals, some vehicles, lots of letters and numbers. Most models print in half an hour, 1 hour tops, which is great. They are simple models, nothing branded, and she wanted a Pikachu.
What the hell is a Pikachu?
For that, you need a computer. The easy way is to install Kidoodle Slicer Studio, which is extremely simple. You can resize and rotate models, you can make vases, and that's basically it. You put the files on a pen drive inside of a Kidoodle folder. These are the models that came with the printer. This is the online catalog. And this is what is on the pen drive. If you slice using the Kidoodle slicer, the models will appear with miniatures. I tried to use Orca slicer and it worked, sort of. I used a generic Marlin profile and I could print this calibration cube. I was happy and I tried something more ambitious. And here I got a problem because I don't know the proper acceleration values, speeds, retraction, start G-code, end G-code, and because of that I got a clog. That I could only fix by unscrewing the print head out of the printer, making it heat, taking off the nozzle and prime filament, screw the nozzle back and install the print head again. I want to use Orca Slicer, Prusa Slicer, Cura, but I really recommend you to wait until Kidoodle releases an official profile, because I don't want to ruin my daughter's toy again. Now I fixed it. Back to Kidoodle Slicer. I prepared some models that you can get on the internet to see if Kidoodle can print them well. The gear bearing needed some work to break free its parts, but here it is, spinning. If you print it a little bigger, it will be easier. This is the Darth Vader bust by David Eastman, printed in half the original size. The Buddha. Low poly Pikachu. And finally, there are two models that I was really curious to print. The tiny owl and the cute mini octopus, both from Mackie Beer, an artist that I just love. The tiny owl is so tiny, I got the wings free, but the head got stuck to the body. I enlarged it to 1.2 times its original size, but still no luck with the head. And finally, at 1.5, the original size, I could break the head free. This is so adorable! And the biggest challenge, the articulated octopus in the original size. The straight version doesn't fit, but he has a curved position that fits the build plate. Here it is. The octopus is special for me because it was one of the first models I ever printed on my Ender 3, 5 years ago, and I failed a few times. Sure, I'm using glue here, but it works. The Kidoodle has a direct drive extruder. It is an all-metal hot end. The cooling fan is clever, it is wide, and you can feel the wind coming through the door. The screen and the print head are great. They are legit 3D printer hardware. But the frame, the box, everything is plastic. It makes clickety-clackety sounds. This is a toy. By the way, the door is not super polished, and I caught Sophie constantly looking through the vents to see inside better. They included this model on the printer. Ta-da! It's a spool holder for normal 1 kilogram rolls. It is too wide. Nope. Yes. Nope. 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 Yes. I hope they change it. If not, I designed my own Infusion 360. Sure. I can see the Kidoodle in schools as well. It is very compact. Every kid could have their own printer. How durable they are, only time will tell. It looks repairable. But again, This is a toy. The Kidoodle is now on Kickstarter. The link is in the description. I have no information about the normal retail price after the launch. Right now, it is very affordable, and my daughter can print stuff on her own.
Pikachu.
Today, she surprised me because I was very tired and I went to take a nap. And when I woke up, she had printed this rocket from the catalog. And she found the pen drive that I had prepared. And she printed the owl and another Pikachu on her own, completely. Like, she turned it on, she put the pen drive, she navigated, found the pen drive option. She did everything. She can print what she wants, when she wants. It cannot be better, right? That is very proud of you, Sophie. Links for the Kidoodle in the description. You can also follow me for free on Patreon. I will put photos of everything we printed on Patreon. And if you have questions, type in the comments and I am happy to answer. In a week or so, I will show a very nice 3D printer for the daddies. So subscribe and I'll see you soon.